Want to get to more breaking news this afternoon. Bomarito Automotive Group Skyfox over a massive water main break near Forest Park. This is near the I-6440 Tam Avenue overpass. Let's get right to photojournalist Stan DeWitt. Stan?
Yeah, Mike, this is actually Turtle Park. It is, you know, the park where all the kids have the big stone turtles, and it's a large, large water main break. But the real serious problem here is this water is flowing over Highway 64.
All right, let's reset here, Stan. If you could take it out wide, we want to just bring everybody up to date. This breaking news we're following is right in Dogtown. This is impacting the eastbound lanes right now of I-6440. Again, this is the Oakland Avenue area of Dogtown, the Tam Avenue overpass there. Here's a MoDOT camera that shows a little bit more of what that backup looks like. Absolutely just pouring out of that hole right now over the median and into the eastbound lanes of I-6440. Thankfully, you can see that traffic has stopped now in that direction. Literally watching this as it unfolds here, it appears the firefighter is giving some instruction to those inside the vehicle. Oh my goodness, look at that. A firefighter has just pulled a small child out of that vehicle. So it was more than just one person inside. Firefighters now carrying a woman to safety. She was inside that van as well. Up over that firefighter's knees as he passes her to a colleague, getting her to safety in the westbound lanes of I-6440. Wow. We want to go now to our reporter, Kelly Hoskins. She is now on scene. Kelly, have you been able to gather any more information about what caused this water main break and how soon crews can get it shut down?
Not at this point. We're just arriving on scene here at Turtle Park. As you can see right here behind me, as we mentioned, in regards to this water main break making the way on this impassable here on Interstate 64 near Tam. That occupied vehicle, as you mentioned, was stranded here in water with the occupants rescued.
Man, check out the ground video now we're showing of the water just pumping out of that hole. This is just north of Turtle Park. You can see what appears to just be an ordinary citizen there getting a close look for himself. We would, of course, encourage him to keep a safe distance from that water.
So there's a couple of new developments here since Mike and I last talked. Westbound 64 is now completely shut down. When we were closing out the show, Mike, you remember it was one lane was still getting through, but you could tell that area was just starting to fill up.
I want to bring in Captain Garen Mosby with the St. Louis Fire Department to tell us what he knows so far.
Right. Essentially what you said, we have a major water main break. Initially, there was a family trapped in the water. It came upon them very suddenly. In a minivan, we were able to get them to safety. Traffic right now is a bit challenging. Eastbound and westbound are currently closed off. Got some cars turning around, exiting back the way they came, and we've got it shut down at Hampton. The water department's on scene and they're working to get the water shut.
It's truly remarkable to see the flow of water.
And and the force that water has been coming out is the same as it has been for the past 40 minutes or so, as we see it from Bomarito Automotive Group Skyfox just gushing onto the highway. First, it was just the eastbound lanes, and now the westbound lanes are closed. Now, as we give you a real-time traffic map of this area that is affected, as you can see, I-64 is closed in both directions.
I want to give you kind of an update of the traffic situation. To our east is Hampton, and I'm going to pan over that way. The highway, obviously, is still closed down. People are still turning around and going up the off ramps. This is Hampton Avenue here. Both Hampton north and south, and then to our north or our west is Skinker. These roads are just bumper to bumper too. So if any way you can avoid this area entirely, you really need to do it.
Kelly, you're on the ground there and that break is right behind you.
Well, Jasmine, I can tell you that the water is coming out a little slower now. There is a huge emergency presence on scene to get this water main break under control. And since that water has slowed just a little bit, it's a good indication that they may be headed in the right direction. But it was a very different story earlier as Bomarito Automotive Group Skyfox was over the flooding here on Interstate 64 that stopped traffic in both directions. The City of St. Louis Water Division has identified this as a 30-inch water main break as the source of the flooding. In addition, as we mentioned, a family was trapped in their van in the water and had to be rescued and brought to safety. And we talked with Captain Garen Mosby about the water main break.
The water came up, you know, talking to the folks that were stranded in it. It's a major break. I can't get into particulars about that. I just don't know enough about it. But it did come upon them suddenly. So right now we're just thankful that everyone in that vehicle got to safety and that there's only one vehicle that's stranded in water.
Fox 2's Mitch McCoy is live along I-64 tonight where things are still shut down. Mitch.
Jasmine Elliott, hello, good evening to you. Take a live look. This is happening right here in the eastbound lanes as the interstate here on I-64 is shut down. A tow truck working to remove the van that everybody has been watching in disbelief today while people were also being rescued from that van. Again, eastbound I-64 completely shut down. Westbound is slow moving here. This was a nightmare scenario as firefighters raced to save lives.
Water everywhere.
So many people were packed just like walking and watching.
This, no doubt, is a sight to see.
It did come upon them suddenly.
As interstate traffic flooded Friday, St. Louis firefighters rushed in with a harrowing rescue captured by Bomarito Automotive Group Skyfox. A family, including a child, saved in the nick of time.
We're just thankful that everyone in that vehicle got to safety and that there's only one vehicle that's stranded in water.
I'm not super surprised.
Up on dry land, Lauren Bankwell barely has running water tonight. She says there's been on and off problems for a while, but never to this scale.
I know we had problems with our water pressure a little bit when they first started, and that got cleared up pretty fast.
The City of St. Louis confirms a 30-inch water main is the source of flooding on I-64 near Dogtown. About 7 months ago, a state audit recommended the city increase revenue for the water division after finding St. Louis did not have sufficient water revenues to adequately maintain the city's water distribution.
We're just grateful that we weren't impacted too much by it.
Stephanie Clark is celebrating her husband's graduation. She says those invited are getting a free pass on being late.
They've been trickling in kind of a little bit later than expected. I think some people are getting stuck even back in the neighborhoods just coming locally. And then we have others that are stuck out on the highway.
Now it's time to figure out how to dry up on the interstate and get water flowing again where it's supposed to.
Thanks, Mitch. And of course, hats off to firefighters who were able to get the family out. Well, the scene causing quite a commotion on the Tam Avenue overpass. Several residents and passersby were stopping to take photos, videos, and just to watch the situation unfold. Fox News' Jordan Williams has reaction from Dogtown neighbors. And Jordan, they got quite a kick out of seeing the gushing geysers, right?
Yeah, that's exactly right, Elliot. It was a troublesome scene for some, but some others really just trying to get a closer look at it that weren't involved in that traffic. The Tam Ave overpass really becoming almost just as flooded as the interstate was, with several people in the neighborhood really just trying to get an up-close look at what was happening here. And while some of the residents I actually spoke with off camera had some issues with their water being shut off, a few of the residents in the area that I spoke to on camera didn't really seem too upset about it.
It's really interesting to see because you always hear about highways getting shut down, but I've never seen it actually here.
Westbound and eastbound drivers backed up, sitting in the heat.
I'm not a traffic guy as is, and this does not appear to be anything that's going away anytime soon. It's nice and hot, so you're going to have the AC going the whole time.
All because of this water main break by the Tam Ave overpass.
It just continued to get higher and higher. And it was entertaining for me.
Thousands of gallons of water gushing onto the interstate, bringing some curious viewers who all had to get a glimpse and take a photo.
It's interesting to see, as long as they're staying safe, which everybody surprisingly was.
Even some dogs taking in the unexpected geyser.
He's been chill. He's been, I don't think it's his thing as much as it has been for me.
The water show becoming an unexpected highlight of an otherwise tame Friday afternoon.
And while that was all going on, I actually chatted with one of the bartenders at Pat's Bar and Grill, the closest business to this water main shutoff. They actually had no issues. While I did mention some residents actually had to have their water shut off. And I know Chris Higgins has been following the traffic closely while this has all been unfolding. And Chris, can you tell us how all this traffic looks right now?
Well, fortunately, Jordan, things have improved in terms of the length of the backup, but there are still cars trapped in a backup there close to where the water main break is. It's right there at TAM, right across from Forest Park in the zoo. The backup on westbound lanes extends west past Hampton, just a little bit past Hampton to the east, not quite as far as it did during the height of the incident when it went all the way up past Vandeventer. On the other end of this, 64 eastbound continues to be backed up to Bellevue Avenue, and that too is a big improvement. You might remember during the height of it, it was backed all the way up to Lindbergh Boulevard.